बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आज मैं आपको प्रैक्टिकल 4 जो है उसकी रिकॉर्डिंग भेज रही हूँ। प्रैक्टिकल 4 का जो टाइटल है दैट इज़ द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप रीडिंग एंड कन्वेंशनल साइन। इफ़ यू रिमेंबर द प्रीवियस प्रैक्टिकल, प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 3 वॉज रिलेटेड टू कन्वेंशनल साइन, सो I had decided to make a sequence of conventional sign with respect to the practical 4. So in practical 4, our main objective and target is to understand what are the topographical maps and how can we easily study the topographical maps, what type of detail a topographical map normally shows, and which type of methods, signs or symbols we can use to understand the topographical maps easily. So this is our main objective to conduct this practical, and for this firstly we need to know what are basically topographical maps. So in the first part I had given you a complete definition of topographical map, and then the main purpose, why do we need to draw the topographical map. So just take a look of topographical map's definition at first. Okay, now you can see on the board there is a proper definition of topographical maps has been written. Topography, basically it's a combination of two words, and everybody knows the topo means place and graphy or the graphian mean is to explain. So in the first part, a very simplest the way to tell you the combination of the word topography. Okay, so topography basically a combination of two words. The first part is topo, it means to place, and the graphy or the graphian is to describe or is to explain. So if we are objected to just to explain the places, the areas, their upper surface of the earth, then we are just related with the topography. If you remember when we were doing the part of plateau, plain and mountains, so most important characteristics at that time we used to discuss, that is the topography of the plain, topography of the plateaus, topography of the mountainous area. And every physical feature has different type of topographical feature. So the upper surface or upper layer features are basically come under the category of the topography, and those are responsible to decide whether the topography is good or bad. Okay, so this is just the meaning of the word topography. Now there is a definition of the topography. A topographical map shows in detail the surface of the earth. This is basically the main agenda. Why do we need to draw the topographical map? Because these are the thematic maps based upon some themes, purpose, and if the cartographer and the people are interested to know about the surface features of the earth, then there is a need to draw the topographical map. So that's the reason we call them not only the topographical map, rather because these types of maps could only be drawn if all the detailed survey will be conducted. So that's the reason we can also call them topographical survey or topo sheet or scenery maps. Okay, scenery maps because they represent a full scenic view drawn on basically large scale, and large scale and small scale discussion we had already done in the previous lecture, because there we had discussed this thing that small scale maps will be like responsible to cover the extensive areas, while large scale maps will just be able to capture or to cover the small area. Okay, so it is known as topographical survey, topo sheet or scenery maps. Now we need to take a look on what is actually the main objective to draw these topographical maps. दीज मैप्स आर बेसिकली ड्रॉन ऑन लार्ज स्केल मैप एंड आई वॉज टेलिंग यू दैट लार्ज स्केल मैप्स आर बेसिकली रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू कवर अ स्मॉल एरिया बट इट शोज एवरी पार्ट इन डिटेल. सो टू मेन पर्पज टू ड्रॉ दीज मैप्स इज टू कवर और इज टू कैप्चर अ स्मॉल एरिया अ स्मॉल सीनिक एरिया और एनी रिक्रिएशनल पॉइंट और एनी टोपोग्राफिकल फिजिकल फीचर बट थिंग्स विल बी डिस्कस इन दिस मैप इन डिटेल एंड दैट फीचर इट कुड बी एनी फिजिकल फीचर और कल्चरल फीचर. सो दैट वॉज द मेन पर्पज. ओके राइट आफ्टर द डेफिनेशन एंड इट्स मेन पर्पज नाउ द पॉइंट कम्स द इम्पॉर्टेंस एंड यूजेज ऑफ द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप. सो एज आई हैव अर्लियर सेड टोपोग्राफिकल मैप्स आर एक्सटेंसिवली बींग यूज to understand the physical and the cultural features because these maps are basically constructed by using large scales. So everything will be captured or will be shown in this map will have a very detailed manners. So the first importance and use of the topographical maps are is like that it not only been used by the geographers for their objective rather by different other specialist persons like the army officer, any administrator, the planner, the traveler and the researcher. So any field which needs some area, place or any space information, they will definitely use this topo sheet topographical map. So this is one of the most important use for army officers. They most commonly or widely use these topographical maps when they are entrusted to make a plan of any area. Okay, these maps, because of their information and because of their importance, they were known in the past as storehouse of information. So in the past, as we don't have any other basic equipments to keep the information for a long period of a time in store, so these maps are basically cover and store the information. So that's why they are called as storehouse of information. And it is also been considered in the past that wars have been won by these expertise, like topographical map making is an expertise and how to read these maps, so the wars have been won. So these are basically the importance of the topographical map. Now quickly let's take a look on the topographical map in subcontinent with some history. Okay, the development of topographical maps in subcontinent, that is the historian part, because first time in the subcontinent these maps were made and used by Dr. Envelé in 1752. And at that time, firstly in India, that was needed to establish a department of survey. So establishment of the department of survey in India was took place in 1767, and the major surveyor general was selected at that time, that was the Major James, and its headquarter was at Dehradun. So this is the history or the development procedures of the topographical maps in the subcontinent. A very important use and amendment was done when Colonel William became the General Surveyor General of India in 1802. He started to use the triangular survey. Triangular surveys plays a very important role in the topographical map. And after that, another person whose name was like Sir George, he used different or he done different amendments in using the triangular survey. So topographical maps establishment and its formation and its steps basically deals with a number of eras. Okay, so let's take a look on the conventional signs and symbols, because our practical title was basically topographical map, its reading and conventional sign. So we have discussed what are the topographical maps, their main purpose to draw or to construct, and then we have seen the importance of topographical map with some historical background. Now we need to know हाउ कैन वी रीड द टोपोग्राफिकल मैप बाई यूजिंग द कन्वेंशनल साइंस. ओके, सो कन्वेंशनल साइंस और कन्वेंशनल सिंबल्स आर बेसिकली डिफाइंड एज दीज आर देर आर नंबर और वेराइटी ऑफ फीचर्स वी कैन सी ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ और ऑन ग्राउंड. बट वेन वी नीड टू ड्रॉ दैम ऑन टोपो शीट वी नीड टू टेक अ लुक ऑन सम सिम्बल्स. सो दोज सिम्बल्स एंड साइंस विद रेफरेंस टू टोपो शीट्स आर नोन एज कन्वेंशनल सिम्बल एंड कन्वेंशनल साइन. ओके, there are few important characteristics with respect to the conventional sign. These symbols are not drawn according to any scale. It's very important point. We are not making any diagram or any conventional sign according or by following any rule or any scale. Okay, the main thing is that if you use this conventional sign, not only it will give you the maximum information of your topo sheet, rather it will add more reliability, more legibility to the map, and that map will be helpful more in their manner. So Pakistan survey, jaise ki humne abhi India ka kiya, Pakistan Survey Department has also issued some conventional sign or conventional symbol, and at the like after conventional sign definition, you all need to write down all those conventional signs. So here I'm going to attach or making a video of those conventional signs, a list of it. So just after conventional signs definition, you will write down all those conventional signs, their list. Okay, here you can see the list of the conventional signs which are basically used by the Survey Pakistan Department. The one you can see, the metal road. The second one is comparatively less important metal road with the milestone, unmetal road, less important unmetal road with a bridge. The seventh one is cast track. The eighth one is back track and the pass. The ninth one is footpath with a bridge. The tenth is a bridge without a pier, and the 11th is the causeway, and the 12th is fjord or the ferry. The 13th is path in a stream bed. The 14th is undefined stream. The 5th one is canal, and 6th one is the missionary dam. Isse spelling galat likhe hue hai, lekin ye missionary dam hai. 17th is slopy stream back. 18th is stream back 10 to 19 feet. 19th is stream bank above 19 feet. 20th is dry river with a water channel. The 21 is river with an island, and the 22 is tidal river. 23rd is swam. 24th is reed. 25th is line. 26th is unlined well. 27th is spring. 28th is lake or river with a defined boundary. 29th is limit of the perennial water. 30th is the embankment. 31 is road or the railway embankment. 32 is broken ground. 33 is railway under construction. 34 is telegraphic line. 35 is tunnel. 36 is contour line. 37 is foam line. 38 is rocky slope. 39 is sand flat, and 40th is permanent sand dunes. Okay, now the 41. Tehsil boundary. 42 is international boundary. 43 is sand flat. 44 is state boundary. 45th is village village train junction. Junction hoga, village junction. 46 is port and telegraphic office. 47 is permanent hills. 48 is temporary huts. 49 is tower. 50th is temple. 57 is what has been written. Okay, 51 ko we are like leaving. 52 is church. 53 is mosque. 54 is triangulation point. 55 is benchmark. 56 is tertiary benchmark. 57 is inspection bungalow. 58 is name of place of tribal areas. And here we can see 59 post office, police station, the next one, canal level, cliff, fort, bamboo, rest house, circuit house, grass, shrub, पालमेरिया, 71 इज बेटल नट, 71 इज कॉनिफर, 78 इज टॉम, 73 इज लाइट हाउस, लाइट शिप, द नेक्स्ट वन इज माइन एंड द ग्रेवयॉर्ड. सो दीज आर ऑल द कन्वेंशनल साइन विच पाकिस्तान सर्वे डिपार्टमेंट हैज़ इशूड, एंड नॉट ओनली दीज नेम्स रादर दे हैव देयर सिम्बल्स टू. When you people will start writing this practical 4, and firstly you will write down the definition of conventional sign and their main purpose. So on that blank page you will draw this picture, you will draw this diagram. You can see in detail, this is basically a topographical sheet of the Jhang district. You will not only draw this, rather you will use the same color. The ground will be seen by light yellow color, and you can see here the trees, different colors like orange or red has been used for the roads. The black color is for the swampy areas or any other feature represented by it, and light blue color is for water. So this is actually a topographical sheet of district Jhang. So at first blank page of your practical you will draw this one, and then on a very next page you will start drawing all conventional sign which are mentioned in your syllabus: scattered hut, swamp, cemented road, and all these symbols should be drawn like in the same manner jaisa is bachche ne draw kiya. एक अलग सा पेज शी हैज़ यूज, ठीक है, सेपरेट पेज है इसने यूज़ किया, और इस सेपरेट पेज को ये देखें, इस सेपरेट पेज को जो है उसने अपनी कॉपी पे पेस्ट किया है, और ये सारे सिंबल्स विद देयर नेम्स लिखे हैं. कहीं पे आपको जैसे कि ये यहाँ पे नज़र नहीं आ रहा इसका नेम, ठीक है, तो ये आप बेशक छोड़ दीजिएगा, लेकिन बाकी जिस तरह से इन्होंने किया है आपने भी सेकेंड पेज पर आपने इसी तरह से ये ड्रॉ करने हैं. इसकी एक और कॉन्टिन्यूशन भी है, वो भी मैं आपको दिखा. ये आपका पेज ब्लैंक पेज 3 का आ गया. ब्लैंक पेज 1 पे आपने डिस्ट्रिक्ट छिंग की टोपोशीट बनाई, पेज 2 पे आपने कन्वेंशनल साइंस बनाए जो इससे पहले दिखाए. अब ये ब्लैंक पेज 3 होगा जिस पर आप ये सब ऐसे ड्रॉ करेंगे. जब आप ड्रॉ करेंगी तो आपने सेम यही ब्लैक कलर पॉइंटर यूज़ करना है, इसी तरह से बनाना है, कहीं कोई अपने कलर कोई एडिशन डिलीशन नहीं करनी है. एज़ इट इज़ दीज सिंबल्स विल बी ड्रॉन बाय द सेम कलर एंड सेम मेथड. नाउ दिस इज़ ब्लैंक पेज 4, ओके, सो दिस इज़ ब्लैंक पेज 4 है. अब यहाँ पे ये देखें, ये क्लियरली नज़र आ रहा है कि लेक के स्पेलिंग गलत लिखे हुए हैं, LAKE, और ये ऊपर जो है ये फिजॉर्ड आएगा, ठीक है, तो ये आपने ख़ुद से थोड़ा बहुत ठीक कर लेना है, ठीक है. तो ये दिस इज़ योर पेज 4, ठीक है, पेज 4 तक आपका ब्लैंक पेज पे काम आएगा. अब चलते हैं फौरन से कैसे कन्वेंशनल साइंस को पढ़ा जाता है. Okay, methods of studying the topographical map, there is no specific methods have been mentioned, but the thing is like these are the multi-purpose map which deals physical and cultural features, and all these features have a great geographical value. So whenever there is a need to study those features in a topo sheet, our aim just not only to describe those features, rather we should try to find out the relation, the correlation between and among all those features. So that should be our like main purpose. So this is how we can read a topographical map, and this is how can we better understand the topographical map. What is actually the purpose to draw the topographical map can only be understood if we create a relationship among all those features which are shown on the topo sheet. So this is all about lecture practical 4, and only one lecture was sufficient to complete it. So next lecture, recorded lecture, will be of practical 5. Allah.